tonight.
There is nothing wrong.
They don't make them like that anymore. The 80s was the best for horror movies.
Are you serious? The 80s sucked.
What?
Come on, the cheesy stories, the bad effects, the electronic synth music in every movie.
That's what made the 80s. Horror movies these days are the ones that are shit. Unoriginal ideas, bad acting, overuse of cliches, CGIs, and nothing but gore.
The 80s were gory. Romero.
Yeah, but it was stylized and you can tell that it was fake. Nowadays, they try so hard to make it look realistic that it defeats the purpose of it being entertaining. It's so shocking and disturbing, you don't ever want to watch it again. Whereas the classics, you can sit back, watch over and over, and have fun.
Yeah, classics like The Blob remake or anything by Cronenberg, those movies are disgusting.
Yeah, but they were fun and you can tell that it was fake. The 80s had a style. Those effects, as bad as they may seem today, were all practical.
Okay.
This was before back before CG, back when people had to make things with their bare hands. You can tell there was effort.
Yeah, a lot of effort in those synth tracks too. Ugh, they're so tame.
That was the best part. John Carpenter practically was the 80s. And that's another thing.
What?
Cheesy stories. John Carpenter and other directors like him wrote and rewrote the book on horror movies. Some of the most original stuff came out of the 80s. And now they keep remaking everything from the 80s.
Except anthology movies.
It's a lost art. That and originality.
But nowadays, horror movies actually scare people. They put effort in new and creative ways and freaking people out.
Creative ways? What? Showing an entire movie from the perspective of an idiot who doesn't even know how to hold a camera properly? Stupid found footage films.
Well, at least the plots are drawing from source material to genuinely scare people.
Source material? Like what?
True stories, urban legends.
The only urban legend that scared me was Urban Legends, and that's because that movie sucked.
Seriously though, everything these days in pop culture dealing with modern horror is drawn from some type of urban legend. People use them to prank one another and put it on YouTube, even video games, Slender Man.
Which I never heard of until that game came out.
There are lots of urban legends nobody's heard of. When I was in college, a friend told me about one in particular that I never heard of before, about a man who wears a black trench coat and a fedora. You can never make out his face, but you can always make out his silhouette from afar. Tall, dark figure. He's supposed to be the sign of a bad omen. My friend said that those who see him usually come across him while walking. Whenever he walks past someone, they'll look behind them and notice he's disappeared, and if he has, that means something bad will happen to you.
Sounds made up to me.
Apparently many people around the world have been seeing him for years. I went and looked it up. They say he's like an observer or something, mostly appearing at night and sometimes in dreams, usually scaring children.
Usually?
He's called the Hat Man.
Okay, the intimidation just dropped right there. His name is Hat Man. He wears a hat, so let's call him Hat Man. He's slender, so let's call him Slender Man. I'm bored. Come on, let's go for a walk.
A walk? After everything I just said? If this were a horror movie...
Yeah, the Hat Man would fit us for a hat. Let's go. Coincidence.
Yeah, coincidence.
Keska fuck? You know what? Maybe he's just a fast walker. Maybe he lives in one of the houses nearby.
I've never seen him around here before.
He just moved in?
Let's just keep going. You said you wanted to get some fresh air anyway. Let's go. Don't worry, we've just been spooking each other all night, that's all.
Yeah, I guess so. missing joke?
How the hell were they supposed to know what we were just talking about before we left?
I don't know, but I'm calling the cops.
All right.
Fun in the sun, man. You know what I mean, right, man? Middle class families can't afford to take the kids to Disney World, so you gotta go to the beach with a bunch of other screaming kids and the rest of the middle class. Drowning your sorrows by soaking up some rays. You know what I mean, right, man? Sometimes you just gotta conform, man.
You haven't changed a bit.
Yeah. No, man. I'm all about looking on the good side of things now.
Right. Aunt? Tats? Last time? Last time.
Alright. Let's get this party moving, man. See that guy?
What guy?
That creepy ass guy, man. Standing on the side of the road, all creepy and shit. He had this big hat on. You know, like some kind of hat man. Guy was weird, man.
So, how have you been doing?
Better? Yeah, better, you know.
Being back home is good.
Yeah, I feel pretty good, you know, it's no more issues.
It's good.
Good.
Good. Yeah. Sorry I never visited.
You're a busy man, I understand that.
He's a working man on a tight leash. Yes, sir. Good old working man.
And you're a sponge.
Whoa, man. No need to be hostile. Jeez, what the hell? Why don't you just rip my heart out, man? Not cool, man. Not cool.
So, what's so special about going to your old man's cottage now? It's been forever.
Last chance.
Why's that?
It's not my old man's anymore. Some hotshot development company came in, bought up the whole land, the whole neighborhood. I guess they're just gonna bulldoze the whole thing down, turn it into some high-end condominium, strip mall, some shit like that.
Pigs.
So if your dad sold it, why are we going up?
Well, he still got a key. And property runs off a well, so we got water. There's a backup generator. So there should be enough gasoline in there that we get at least one night of electricity. You know, and that way we've got the whole beach, the whole area to ourselves, you know. And that's good considering Mart's antisocial tendencies.
Hey, man, I got lots of friends. More friends than you.
Shit, it's been what, 10 years since the last time the three of us came up here together?
Yeah, high school.
Shit, that was a long time ago. We're here.
Well, look at that. She still looks great.
Yeah, she's still standing, eh?
So, what do you think?
I can't believe it's taking us this long to get back out here.
It's been a while. Whatever.
She looks great.
Mart, man, grab the cooler with the beer. Meet me out back. Okay, I'm going to the pump house. Hans, pick a bed. Make yourself comfortable, okay?
All right.
Oh, look at this place. Still standing. Last chance, boys.
Okay, guys. So this whole place, the water runs off the well system. So we got water, okay? Now in the pump house back there, backup generator should have enough gasoline. Give us enough electricity for a night. We're good, okay?
Electricity? Water? What about the essentials of life? Internet? Cable?
You're gonna have to do without for a night, man. You're not gonna have cellular data. You're not even gonna have a phone signal out here.
You gotta be kidding me. How am I gonna blow up to all my followers?
Switch to the pumps back here. Just give me a second. I got it.
Word business, man.
Well, while the fridge is cooling down, the ice in the cooler should hold, boys.
Cheers. 10 years later, 20 pounds heavier, man. Except for maybe 30 for Hans here.
I'm the bringer of truth, man.
You know, I'm gonna miss this place.
Well, I got something that might cheer you up, man.
What the hell, man? You're only here for one night.
Yeah. Hope it's gonna be enough.
Come on, man, you know I don't like that stuff around me.
Must have slipped my mind, man.
Put it away.
What are you afraid of, man? There's no one around.
What's the problem? Man, why did you have to bring that? Can't we just sit around and have some beers, relax?
Fine. We'll partake somewhere else then.
Mark! Come on, Mark!
Let him go. That was kind of fun. Like you said, antisocial tendencies.
Him or me?
That'd make a killer bong. What the hell, man? Not cool.
Today's done, so he gets high on you, and the energy's...
Do it all the time. I play Xbox, watch a horror movie, something.
Oh man, we watched a lot of horror movies. I mean a lot.
Man, we love them.
Shining.
The Thing.
Halloween.
Hellraiser.
Earth Diggers.
Yeah. Remember in high school? Yeah, you made that movie, you took film or something?
Of course, I made so many. You were always in it too. Of course, you were the leading man type. Yeah. The guy who survived.
Maybe back then, not anymore. Now I'm just a 28-year-old, out of shape, people want to see you, there's nothing but work.
You gotta give yourself some credit, though. If this were a horror movie, between the two of us, I think you're the only one who would actually survive.
If this was a horror movie, I think we'd both be dead pretty quickly.
Oh, I almost forgot. I brought something. I've got something to show you. I was gonna wait till the Martman got back, but who knows if he's coming back now.
Yeah, it's completely dark out there. He's got to be lost in the woods or something now.
He's an adult. He can take care of himself.
He is?
No, I'm just going to go grab it from the car.
Hang on one sec.
Take your time.
Oh, Jesus! Tats!
Whoa. What?
It's happening! It's actually happening!
What's happening?
Mart!
What about
He's dead!
What do you mean, Mart?
Shit, that means I'm next!
Hunt, have you lost your mind? What are you talking about?
It's actually happening! The horror movies! I mean, Mart's dead and there's a killer out there and he's gonna get us and I'm a dead man!
Wait, have you lost your mind? What are you talking about?
If horror movies, you're the leading man type. If anyone's gonna survive, then it's gonna be go! Whoa, wait. I always knew I'd get it like this from an escaped lunatic from a mental asylum. Pissed off because your kid was neglected and killed at the camp resort when the camp counselors were supposed to be watching. Angry mob. You were horribly disfigured by an angry mob that was chasing you. Why the hell are you doing this? Sherrod, you are.
Hey, bud, are you okay?
No, I'm completely fine.
Okay, see ya.
That was sarcasm, asshole!
So, finally finished the script.
And?
Don't know yet. Find out this afternoon if anyone wants it.
I meant, how does it end? You've been struggling with this for weeks and keeping me in the loop.
Come on, Doc, you know you gotta wait till it comes out.
Okay, then you can use the grosses to bill me for these sessions about your superstitions that you constantly worry about.
Well then, you're sitting on a gold mine, Doc.
Look, I know it's your job, but I think you take your research into certain subject matter a little too seriously. Especially when you're watching those viral videos and reading that creepypasta late at night. It seems to add fuel to the fire, if you will.
Well, you always said to expose myself to what bothers me. Writers draw from their fear, right?
Right, but you have to take it with a grain of salt. Expose yourself to realize that it's not real. Just centuries of superstition and folklore. You still see it as a fear. That's a problem.
I know. I can't help it. It's always scared me. Which is why I thought it'd be a good change of scenery for me. A horror movie, that is.
And how is that process this time around?
Not bad. I'm just worried whether it's gonna fly with the studio. Ever since I started writing this one, I've been worrying a lot more lately. Like, a lot more than usual.
Because you put so much pressure on yourself.
And I'm still having the thoughts, too. The auditory ones. The things where it's I'm saying things, but it's things I don't want to say. But things that I'm afraid of coming true. Like not voices in my head, but it's like it's me, but it's not me. If that makes any sense.
So you're still afraid you're jinxing yourself?
Yeah, but like, with everything. Every day now.
You know, I guarantee that if you deliberately wish bad upon me, it will not happen. In fact, I want you to go home tonight. I want you to wish that I lose my cell phone. Okay? Just something insignificant.
I'll see. No promises. I've got to try and get through the next few days without letting my thoughts get to me.
Don't let them. They're just thoughts. If you let it bother you, it'll only fuel your fears further. You have to learn to ignore your thoughts, even when they're verbal. If you worry about it, it will happen. Oh, in your mind, that is.
Yeah. I gotta stop talking to myself, too, when it happens.
Yes. Just remember, Murphy, because you are interested in the paranormal, doesn't necessarily mean you have to believe it.
You know, I'm still afraid of the dark.
Most people are, even when they grow up.
And the monster under my bed, and the monster in the closet.
That's just ridiculous.
I know. I still check under the bed and in the closet before I go to sleep. It's pathetic. It's routine. I've had it since I was a kid. I've got to break it.
And do break it. I want you to promise me tonight that you won't check. Make that your goal for this week. Ignore the intrusive thoughts. With an anxiety disorder, you must realize that it's part of your disorder and not rational.
Time's up.
All right, Murphy. Just remember, if you worry about it, it'll happen. So, don't worry. Good luck on the script.
Thanks, Doc.
Oh, see you next week.
Same bad time, same bad channel. Just what I need, something freaky.
What if it was something bad?
Must be tripping. Oh, fuck. Oh, come on. Thank you.
What if it's face down? Face down. Bad luck.
To hell with it. 1 cent is 1 cent. Next thing you know, I'll be stepping in a puddle. Let it be good news.
What if no one liked the script?
Lenny, what do you know? What do you say?
Still drinking it black?
Just give me a second.
If I ever have to use this.
Not tonight. Still living in the sticks? It's gotta be 5 o'clock somewhere. Did anyone read it?
No.
Why not?
Because I read it.
What's wrong with it?
We mean what's wrong with it. It sucks. It's got no heart. It's just cliche garbage.
It's a horror movie.
I know, but it's missing something.
So what? No one will buy it?
Of course someone will buy it. It's got your name on it. If you want me to sell tomorrow, I'll sell tomorrow. If you want to make a couple of bucks. But your last movie sold 7 figures. Now, if you rework it a little, put a little soul into it, I can make another 7 figures. Look, I get it. You got stupid. You put all your money into meds, therapy with that quack. Doesn't mean you have to hold yourself in the middle of nowhere. There's still people that care about you, give a damn about you. Not many, but a few. Me included.
And that quack. Lenny, you just want to make money.
Okay, you got me. But I don't make money unless you make money. So you know what? Take a couple of weeks, rework it, I'll be back, and whatever you have, I'll sell it. Deal?
Deal.
Oh, one more thing. Keep the shadow creature. I like that.
Deep inside the shell I crawl into, crying alone, alone. Please stay away, I just don't want to see you. The things that you say, I know there are lies, but I don't understand what the story is about. Explain to me, please.
7 figures.
Keep the shadow creature.
People like their creature features.
What the hell was that today? The guy in the disappearing act? One thing after another. Everything I thought happened? It has to be a coincidence. Just bad luck.
Sorry, Doc.
What if the monsters in the closet were real? What if there were monsters under the bed? Where and how did these myths originate? Why is it we all fear these things as children? How could every child in the world share the same fear if they weren't real?
Shut up!
What if they are real?
Perfect day.
they die when I die.
What if I die, you die? Creature features.
What if it doesn't work?
Sorry, are you okay?
No, I mean, no, it was my fault. I'm sorry. I was in a rush.
Well, as long as you're okay. My name's Kendra. What's yours?
David.
Hey, I know that I just almost killed you, but do you think you maybe want to go for a drink?
Well...
Like, you know, you're probably in a rush. I'm sorry. Just never mind.
It's not important. I'd love to get a drink.
Yeah? Great. Actually, do you know of this bar just up the road if you want to go?
Sure.
Get along with people, but when I saw you, though, I thought for some reason we'd just get along. Sorry, I wouldn't want to get your boyfriend jealous.
What makes you think that I have one?
Are you kidding me? There's no way that you don't have a boyfriend.
That's really nice, but I actually just got out of a relationship. It was really bad. But I'm single now.
Well, would you want to see someone, that is?
Yeah, maybe if it's the right person. Do you not drink? Are you recovering or something?
Oh, no, it's nothing like that. It's just, I don't ever drink.
Why?
When I was growing up, my father was an alcoholic, and just decided I was better off without that stuff. I probably should have mentioned that when you asked me for a drink, though.
Well, I'm really glad you came, though, David. I'm having a lot of fun.
Who's there? Come on out. Who's there?
hell's going on here?
David?
Who's that?
David, it's me.
What? Who's saying that?
Don't you remember me, David?
How do you know my name?
It's me, David, your friend Mina.
Mina?
Yes!
How did you get in here? Where are you?
You can't see me, remember, David?
I know I can't see you, so come out!
No, David, I'm right here. I'm just invisible, remember?
Visible? Wait. Your voice sounds sort of familiar.
Don't you remember, David? We used to play hide-and-seek all the time. I always won, though.
Mina?
That's right. You remembered.
No. This can't be right.
What do you mean? Aren't you glad I'm here?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't seen or heard from you in years.
I'm back now.
So, you're real?
Of course I'm real, dummy.
Just that most imaginary friends are actually real.
Well, I am.
So, where have you been all this time? I mean, I haven't talked to you since I was a kid.
You grew up, David. You didn't need me anymore.
Need you? Mina? Mina? I should lay off the caffeine. What's up, Doc? Doc, some really weird stuff's been happening to me the last few days.
I would think so, since apparently a 24-hour cancellation policy means absolutely nothing to you.
What?
You missed your last appointment, David.
Oh, sorry about that. Something came up last minute.
Which was?
Well, I was on my way to your office, and I met this girl.
A pretty lady. Man's greatest distraction.
Doc, you have no idea. We bumped into each other, we ended up going for drinks.
Really? A date? How'd that go?
It was great, Doc. I never knew I could get along with someone so well.
That's great, David. Good for you. You're making a lot of progress with your emotional and social detachment. Tell me about her. What's she like?
She's great, Doc. Her name's Kendra. She's kind, she's quirky, and Doc, she wears these 3D glasses all the time. It's so cute.
That's great, David. Just be sure not to rush into it too quick. My ex-wife seemed nice at first, but she turned out to be a real monster. So, is there anything else you wanted to talk about today?
Oh, right. Really weird started happening to me about a week ago. Right after my date with Kendra, in fact. Doc, I started hearing voices. Well, I mean, just one. But it was, Mina, my old imaginary friend.
Interesting. Very interesting. The same invisible friend you had as a child?
Yeah, I hadn't talked to her in years. Doc, I'm not going crazy, am I?
No, my boy, you're not going crazy. I think what we're dealing here is simply your mind's defensive mechanism against the emotional stress caused by this new relationship.
In English?
What I mean was, your childhood was very rough. Your mother was not there, and when your father drank, he would often hit you. This invisible friend of yours, she was around during this time, right?
Yeah, she was.
I would venture a guess that she disappeared around the time your father abandoned you, right?
Yeah, that seems right, Doc.
Since your mind couldn't handle the emotional or physical stress of your father beating you, what would have been a typical imaginary friend became a lot more valuable to you. She allowed you to cope with your surroundings. After your father disappeared, you simply learned to shut other people out. Your friend was no longer needed as a defense mechanism because you established a new one.
Okay, Doc, so my current problems replaced her in my life? Why is she back all of a sudden?
Well, your emotional detachment stops you from forming relationships with new people, correct? With this new girl, Kendra, you've gone beyond that and actually formed a relationship. As such, your mind is dealing with the anxiety brought on by these kinds of emotions. Your friend, Mina, is actually your mind's way of keeping you safe from something it feels threatened by.
What's that?
A real, genuine relationship with another person.
I'm here, don't fear. I'm here, my dear. And you thought you knew your mind. Then one day you seemed to find that your thoughts would make even a villain frown.
Kendra. Yeah, I had a good time too. No, I'm not doing anything Friday. Your place. Sure. Should I bring anything? Alright, I'll see you then.
David, I don't like that girl.
Mina?
I don't think you should see her anymore. I don't like her.
Who? Kendra? Why?
I just don't like her, David.
Well, I like her. A lot.
I don't care. You shouldn't see her anymore. She's not right for you.
I'll decide who's right for me.
That bitch only wants to hurt you.
Hey, that's enough.
Just stay home with me instead.
I want to have a social life for once. I really like her, and you can't support me, then you're not my friend.
I'm trying to support you. That slut is only going to make things worse for you.
Wait a minute. This is exactly what Doc was telling me.
What?
You're just my mind trying to stop me.
No, I'm your friend.
No, you're not. You're not even real, Mina. You're just part of me that's scared of getting close to anyone. But I'm not scared of Kendra. I don't need you anymore, Mina. Mina? How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks.
Come on in.
Like your place.
Thanks. So I'm just making dinner. Would you mind giving me a hand?
Sure. Not much of a cook, though.
Yeah, would you mind just setting the table for me? That'd be really great.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Cool, my plates are just right here.
David, you need to leave.
Mina, what are you doing here?
She's not right for you, David. You should go.
Not this shit again. I'm so sick of you. What are you doing following me around in public? Stop telling me what to do.
What?
You're so controlling.
Is everything okay, David?
No, I don't want to hear it. You're not even real. I know you're just in my head.
What does that even
go mean? Away!
This is my house!
Just go away!
David, you don't need to set the table if you don't want to. I didn't mean to make you feel bad or anything.
What? Oh, Kendra, no. It's not what you think.
What's not what I think?
Sorry, I wasn't talking to you. I was talking to Mina.
What?
This is gonna sound really strange, but I'll explain.
So, your psychiatrist says that this Mina is just you thinking that you don't want to be with me?
No, I just never had a real relationship since my father left. He used to beat me. I was always afraid to make friends. Well, I mean, except for Mina. It's not you, though. I know I want to be with you. But
I'll understand if you don't want to see me anymore.
I think I understand. You know, you're afraid of opening up. And I'm more than willing to help you do that.
Really? Then...
I'm more than happy to stay with you. You know, you're a really sweet guy, and I'm so lucky to have found you.
No, Kendra. I'm the lucky one.
Oh, are these the pictures?
Yeah. What? What the hell? Has Mina still been talking to you?
No, not since earlier. I mean, I thought that opening up to you really helped.
I'm glad I could help. You know, I really didn't like the idea of having to share you with her.
You won't have to.
No, David, stay with me instead.
I just hurt her again. What?
I just hurt her too.
You bitch!
You can't have him! Hurt you, David.
No, she won't, Mina. We've already been through this.
She's going to hurt you. I have to stop her.
Mina, please. We've been friends since we were kids. Just trust me.
No!
Are you sure this is the friend that you had since you were a kid?
But I won't let her hurt you.
Remember now. She was just trying to protect me from him.
David, she's trying to kill us!
Why now?
Get away from her!
Thank you.
I won't let you hurt him!
I will always protect you, David.
Hi, Doc? Yeah, it's David. Hey, listen, I was wondering if we could up my appointments
to twice a week.
As a matter of fact, something just opened up.
Dude, I had a late night last night.
You had a late night? Try fucking 12 years of late nights.
Yeah, well, I did my time, too.
Your time? You did 2 years and you were out.
You're right. Let's not dwell on it. You're out now. So what do you want to do? You want to go see your mom?
No, I want to find some work, man. We need money.
Shit, all right. I mean, can we at least get a drink first?
Okay, fine. You got any smokes on you?
No, man. I quit that shit years ago.
Dude, you fucking with me?
Fuck yeah, I am. Figured you'd be jonesing as soon as you get out. Picked you up a pack on the way.
Sweet. So how's Uncle Bill doing?
Ah, shit. His dementia's getting worse. Poor old bastard's lost.
Oh shit, that sucks, man.
Yeah, it does. And to top it off, Mom's all hopped up on drugs. She's in fucking La La Land.
Jesus.
Yeah, whatever. They're a dying breed. Listen, there's somebody I want you to meet before we go grab a drink.
We can get laid after we get a job done.
Nah, man, nothing like that. We're just gonna talk to somebody that can help us unload some stuff. He's got a pawn shop.
What's this? I thought we were going to a pawn shop. This looks like somebody's garage.
It's exactly what it is, man. All the stolen shit's inside. But all the good shit, right here in the house. Oh yeah, by the way, try to be nice.
Come in.
Lars.
Look at these shifty fucking weasels. Melvin, how's it hanging, brother?
12 inches to the left.
Yeah, you wish. And who's this guy giving me the evil eye?
That's my cousin Bruce. Bruce, this is Lars.
Oh, nice to meet you. Ditto. Welcome to the land of living. Any friend of Melvin's a friend of mine.
Some place you got here.
Nah, this is my Oma's place. I just hang around and take care of her.
And buy and sell stolen shit out of her garage?
Hey, man. That's how I take care of her. She's a sick old lady. Plus, I gotta keep this shit low key.
And that's why we're coming to you, Lars. To keep shit low key. Isn't that right, Bruce?
Yeah, whatever.
I thought you guys are here to talk business.
Yeah, about that. We're going to be bringing in some merch in the next few days, so just wanted to give you a heads up.
Yeah, you know the routine. Just shoot me a text and I'll meet you guys out back to unload the stuff.
Right on, Lars.
Take it easy, man. Nice meeting you again, Bruce.
Couldn't pick a more discreet vehicle?
What do you mean, man? This is my work truck.
Why didn't you just bring a tank in case the shit hit the fan?
Shit's not gonna hit the fan, dude. It's gonna be easy. In and out.
This house is pretty small, man. You think there's anything good in there?
Oh yeah, man. This guy's a huge nerd. He's got everything. Collectibles. He's got a new Xbox, PS4. He's got everything.
PS4?
Shit, I didn't even know there was a PS3.
Yeah, man. You've been in a prison for a long time. You ever see one of these? It's a cell phone.
Smart ass. How do you know this guy?
I work with him. Said he was going to some convention this weekend, so nobody's around.
You cool with robbing a friend?
Oh, he's not my friend, man. I hate this guy. He's a fucking douchebag. And you know what? I think I might even take a shit in one of his boots.
All right, let's do this. Bring the masks?
Oh, shit, yeah, I almost forgot. Oh, yeah.
What the fuck is this?
What do you mean?
Where'd you get these?
I found them in my mom's gym bag.
I ain't wearing this.
What do you mean, man? I got these bandanas. You want to try one of those?
Forget the mask. Let's just do this.
Okay, man. Well, I'm wearing the mask. I don't give a shit what you're doing.
Would you take that fucking thing off?
You're right, Bruce. I can't see shit with that thing on.
Melvin, let's go. We got everything.
Look what I found.
What of it? It's a BB gun.
It's not just a BB gun. It's an official Red Ryder carbon action 200 shot range model air rifle.
You're kidding me? You're gonna shoot your eye out with that thing.
No, I'm not. I'm keeping it, Bruce. I'm keeping it.
All right, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna lay low tonight. Tomorrow morning, we're gonna take this stuff to Lars.
Sounds good.
All right, let's load up these boxes and get the hell out of here.
All right.
What's happening, boys?
Not much.
What you got for me?
I think you're gonna like this shit, dude.
Yeah, just give me a sec, right?
Oma! Oma! Grandma! Turn that fucking shit down!
Oh, people. Sorry, guys. Bring that shit in here. Alright, let's see what you guys brought me.
Like I said, man, some good shit here.
Right on. I like this. I like it. PS4, nice. Oh shit, what happened to you?
Don't worry about him. The idiot shot his eye out.
Let's just forget about this. What can you give us for this?
You guys want a beer or something first?
Yeah, I'm good for a beer.
No, no, we're good.
Yeah, eh? Alright. How about 1,500?
How about 2,000? Least right. $2,500 here.
All right. Let me just go get you some cash. I'll be right back, all right? Man, there's a lot of junk in here.
I told you, man, he keeps the good stuff in the house.
Oh, yeah? The cash, too?
I don't know. I guess.
Does he live here with his grandma?
No. He lives on the other side of town. Why? What are you thinking?
Alright, 2 G's.
Sweet.
We good?
I'm good.
Alright, Melvin?
Yeah, Lars.
Good doing business.
You too, man. Thanks.
Bruce?
We out. See that, Bruce? Easy cash, man. A few more jobs like that, we'll be rolling in it. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Thank you.
money, we're in the money. We've got a lot of what it takes to get along. We're in the money, the skies are sunny. Old man depression, you are through, you done us wrong. We never see a headline about a bread line today.
Sure you don't want to do this later?
What's the problem? You said no one was home.
No, there isn't. I got a tip that the family's on vacation.
What's the problem? This should be easy, right? Let's do it.
Okay, yeah, I guess. Right.
Is there like an alarm system or something?
Simple security system. Nothing we haven't seen before.
Good. What are we waiting for? Let's do this.
All right, let's go. Plugs, man, like, why'd you have to kill him, man?
You want to play the blame game? This is your fault. You said nobody was home.
I fucked up, okay, man? But you didn't have to kill him.
Yeah, I did. They saw our faces, okay? Now give me your phone.
What do you want with my phone?
Shut up and give it to me. I'm calling Lars right now. We're getting rid of this shit.
He's not gonna be happy about this, man. He's not gonna be fucking happy at all.
I don't give a fuck.
Be on the lookout. Several witnesses have reported two idiots fleeing the scene of a murder in a red 98 Dodge Ram after gunning down a family of three. That is all. Now turn to Al Jolson.
God damn it. Fuck, relax, Melvin. You idiots realize you're all over the news?
What do you mean, we're all over the news?
Don't play stupid, Melvin. You murdered that family.
Oh, fuck, I knew it, man.
Shut the fuck up, Melvin.
Fuck.
Get your truck off my property. That was seen at the crime. Cops will be looking for it.
Fuck.
Melvin, shut up.
I guess we're gonna have to do this quick. We got this box of jewelry. It was all we were able to grab.
Are you kidding me right now? I don't want any of this shit. Take your box and your chucklehead cousin over here and get the fuck out.
We better just go, man.
We're not going anywhere till we get world.
I'm not paying you squat, you piece of shit.
Oh yeah? Is this how we're gonna play it?
Guess so. Guys, let's chill out here.
What are we doing? Fuck.
You bring a gun to my grandma's house? I deal with shitheads like you every day. You don't think I come armed?
Just give us the fucking money.
Please, Bruce. Bruce, don't do this.
Shut the fuck up, Melvin. Stop being a fucking coward.
You better listen to your cousin, Bruce. You're gonna end up with a hole in the back of your head.
How about we both take a shot? And if I'm left standing, I'll go in there, take care of your grandmother, clean her up.
Don't you dare touch my Oma.
Come on, Lars. Just give him what he wants. We'll be out of here.
Fuck you. And you? I didn't trust you the minute you walked through that door. You want your money? Here. Consider this your severance pay. Get the fuck out. I don't want to ever see you again, or I'll kill you.
Lars, man, I'm sorry. I'm sorry about this whole thing.
Take the fucking box and get out of here.
I'll take the box. I'm sorry.
Well, that went smooth. What do we do now? Get rid of that fucking truck.
I like that truck.
It took you so long, man. I texted you like an hour ago.
It's pretty hard to get around when you ain't got no wheels.
What happened to your truck?
I had to get rid of it, remember? You killed that family.
So what's up? Why'd you call me here?
You need some work, man. I'm broke. Like, we need to get working again.
Yeah, well, who do you think you're gonna sell stuff to? Remember, you screwed that up. I think I'm just gonna go back to construction. You know, I could put a good word in for you.
Fuck that, man. I ain't fucking going to do labor work. There's gotta be an easier way to make some money.
Well, if you figure it out, let me know, because I'm not gung-ho about going back to that shit. Can we get up and walk somewhere? My fucking ass is hurting.
Yeah, let's go. Ugh.
I got an idea.
Oh, yeah? Can't wait to hear this.
Let's hit Lars's grandmother's house. One last big job, man. That's where she keeps everything. Money, stock, inventory.
I don't know, man. He's fucking crazy. I don't think I'd be messing with him or his grandma. I haven't even met the lady.
One last job, man. Clean him out, skip town, find somebody to sell the shit to. And then you can go fucking do your construction or whatever the hell it is you want to do.
Well, one last job better pay off good so I don't have to go back to that shit. Okay, fine. I'm in.
One last job.
Sounds good. Fuck construction. Don't you think it's a little early to be doing this right now?
No, man, she's an old lady. She's probably been asleep for 3 hours.
I don't know, man. I think the neighbors are looking at us right now.
No, man, we're gonna make this quick. Come on.
Okay.
Here, point down at the door.
Yeah, I got it. I can tell you, the neighbors are looking at us, man.
Let's try the back door.
What the fuck, Melvin? What the fuck are you wearing?
What, this? Yeah, from my mom's gym bag.
Flashlight to find the can.
Oh, come on, man.
Check your phone. I think your phone's got a flashlight. Yeah, you see? Just hit that. See, man? This is a better flashlight than this one.
Okay. Be quiet.
Yeah. Wish me luck. Worst time.
Bruce.
you call me?
Hey, I heard something.
Yeah, I can hear it.
I think it's the old lady.
We're gonna have to take care of her.
Oh, man.
I think I found the safe. All right, I'll be right up.
All right. Taquitos, man. I had like 12 of them before I came.
Shut up. All right, it's fine. Safe's downstairs.
Hello, sweet boys. How nice of you to come visit an old lonely lady like myself. You boys look famished. Let's go to the kitchen and see if we can fill those bellies. My grandson must have sent you boys. What a good boy to send his granny someone to play with. Let me see what I can find. Oh, I've got some sweets. You boys like sweets? What am I saying? Of course you do. All boys your age like sweets. I've got Turkish delights. Don't be shy. Take that off. Come on. See? I knew you'd like that. Let me see what else I can find. You might want to put that down, young man. I wouldn't want you to
break it!
That wasn't very nice, boys. Not very nice at all. Grandma's gonna have to teach you a lesson.
Fucking run, man! Run! Fucking front door! Fucking sit here.
Yeah, well, I think I gotta go again, man. Oh, man, I told you this was a bad idea, man. Oh, fuck.
Shut up.
First the fucking taquitos, now this shit. This is already going bad.
Shut up, Calvin. Oh, hey, James, I gotta tell you.
Oh, fuck, man. You know what, man? We're gonna die here. Bruce, we're gonna fucking die here tonight.
We're dying here, man. We're gonna get out of here.
We're going to hell. We should have never killed those people. Oh, God. He's punishing us right now.
This is God.
Shit,
it's the work of a witch. Lars' grandma's a fucking witch.
I can't believe we killed those people. And for what? A couple grand? Oh, man. Shit. I can't believe you talked me into this.
Oh, man. Melvin, shut your bloody trap right now before I fucking shut it for you. You need to focus right now.
Oh, shit, I got no bars, man. Give me your phone, man.
What?
I got an idea.
What are you gonna do?
I'm calling the cops, man.
Are you kidding me, man?
Man, we're in trouble, man. Hello? What the fuck? Something's going on with your phone, man. Get away from us, you crazy bitch!
Fuck this, man. We're getting out of here.
Oh, fuck, man. I don't want to go back up there, man.
Count three, man. Run for the front door.
Running for the front door? That's your plan?
got a fucking better one, man?
No, I guess not. Shit, man.
Your mother with that mouth? Why don't you give Granny a kiss?
Get off!
You wait your turn!
Just do it. Just kill me too. Please. Just do it, alright? I see someone. Hey! Help me! Help me!
Thank you.